Hi, this is Susan, and welcome to Zoho Quick Tips. There's an area inside of Zoho called personal settings, where it's one thing that the admin can't control, but it's really important that all of your employees update that area. There's a signature area, you can change the color of the menu bar. There's a lot of options that you really should look at it. Let's take a look at how you might change your own personal settings. One of the first things you should do when you start to use Zoho is to update your personal settings. All personal settings are handled in the tools area by clicking the tools icon. So if I was someplace else, I would click on tools to display the setup. This is something that you need to do as a user for yourself. It's something that your admin cannot do for you or cannot make these changes. So I'm going to go start with the personal settings over here. First of all, I'd like to suggest that you add a photo of yourself. And even though it seems kind of funny sometimes, it really is helpful if you're in a multi-user environment. So right here, I'm on somebody's record, and I'm going to go down to notes. And notice how, as the other users have entered a note, I can see their little avatars. This one I can't see, and it's actually me. So I could look at the people's names, but it seems like it's a lot easier if I could just see their face. So it's pretty easy to do. You just point to the avatar and you click change, and you browse your local files and go find a picture that works well for you. I'm going to go here and just pick a photo. When the photo comes in, you have the ability to kind of size it. You don't have to take the whole photo, but kind of put the eyes in the center of the photo and then click crop and set. So then you have your photo. So I'm going to go back to this page right here and do a refresh. And notice that the photo will appear on the note at the bottom of the screen so that you can kind of see very quickly who's entering notes on the different users. While you're here, you probably also want to update some of your information. So I'm just going to point to the little pencil to the right of my name, and it gives me the ability to put in my phone and put in my mobile phone and put in other pieces of information. The advantage here is that when you have signatures on some of the email templates, there is a way that you can include whatever elements you have in here on those signatures, so it works actually really well. You can also include social profiles. These would help you connect with, there's a social link on each person's record, and you just have to click and authorize the apps as you go through, and that way your personal profile is connected to. This is not connecting a corporate profile. This is only for connecting your own links in these social profiles. I also suggest that everybody look at their time zone. Very frequently, the time zone will be off. In this case, I'm set correctly, but when you first start, it's usually like Pacific Daylight Time or something like that. Then if you set up the calendar to sync with your other calendar, your Google calendar, your Outlook calendar, the time zones will be different. So just make sure that your time zone is correct for you. You can type in like the name of the time zone if you like, or if you know what number it is, -6 or minus whatever, you can type that in as well. However you want to get it in there, just be sure that your time zone is correct as you're starting out. I'm going to skip this because only an admin can update the territories. The signature is really great for when you're sending email outside of Zoho. So I'm going to go back to this record. Certainly when you're starting out, I could click this email hyperlink and it will open up my default email. If I'm using Google, it'll open up a Gmail window. If I'm using Outlook, it'll open up an Outlook new message window. This send email button up at the top allows you to use pre-designed templates inside of Zoho, which is another video. But I'm going to click send email, and notice that when it comes up, it just comes up as a blank email. I can choose a template. I'm just going to choose a random template for right now. And notice that there's no signature on either of these. So I'm going to cancel out of here and go back, because when I send email out of Zoho using that send email link, I want my signature to appear. So each person has to put in their own signature. Usually what I kind of recommend is that you just go to whatever your normal package is, and I would just say, you know, copy one of your signature out of your normal email and then just paste it in here. So you can do something like that, or you can just do it manually because you can see that you have all the ability up here to change the color, change the bold, change the font style, anything that you want to. You can even, if you want to, hit a hard return there. And if you want to, you can add a logo. So I'm just going to click this little picture right here icon to say insert image, and I'm going to go choose a file. In this case, I'm promoting my book at the bottom of my signature, so I'm going to put that in. But I could put in a company logo if I wanted to, but I'm just going to pick the book and wait for it to upload, and then I'm going to click insert. And so now each time I send out my signature, I could have whatever it is, all the information I want for my signature, as well as a graphic. So easy to do. You can restrict. This is probably more an admin feature where, let's say, you want to restrict someone to only be able to access their Zoho CRM from within the company walls or from within particular areas. This kind of helps prevent any kind of hacking from other locations. I don't see this used very often. Sometimes this particular section right here, the sort order preference, let me go back to a list view. You know, when you sort a name view, you'll notice it always, by definition, it will sort by the first name and not by the last name. That really bugs a lot of people. So this would be where you could change it to last name, first name. And I'm going to come back over here and hit refresh, sort it again. Now it's sorting by last name instead of first name, which is, you know, kind of, it depends on how you like it. The other way, sometimes this was an older way of handling it, and you may have done this before, but I would recommend that you kind of go back. People would say, well, I'd like it for it to be last name, salutation, first name. So I'm going to change it to that so you can see what it looks like. Go back over here and click refresh. And in this case, it's going to, when I look at particular records, I'm going to refresh the list. And notice how it displays the last name. I actually don't like this. I find it very disconcerting to see the last name, and there's no comma. So I don't really care for this method, but people used to do it because that was the only way they could get it to sort by last name. But now they have this new sort order preference. So I'm going to take mine back to salutation, first name, last name, which works better for me. Finally, in this view, the default color for the menu bar at the top of the screen is black. It's very easy for you to change your color bar if you like very quickly. It changes it only for you. It doesn't change it for anyone else in the company. And notice all the changes are instantaneous. So let me go back because I don't think I showed you this. I'm going to pick Ethan for a second here, and I want to send an email now to Ethan. Let me just click send email. Notice, first of all, it's going to start with my signature. Remember, before it started with a blank. And now I'm going to choose a template, and we'll just say I'm going to pick something about, he asked me about importing. And I'm going to pick a template about importing because I like that one. Notice it still maintained my signature, but the template also had a little PDF file automatically attached. So it's easy for me to send it out and get it out the door. So I hope you see that it really makes a lot of sense, that your personal settings. Thanks for watching the video. If you found this tip helpful, be sure to give it a thumbs up, and you should also subscribe to this channel if you want to be notified when I upload more tips. As always, if you need any help in using or customizing your Zoho CRM, or even in training your team, give us a shout. You can find our contact info in the information box below.